In this video, we are going to see Photoshop timeline control for video editing and creating GIF animation. In order to demonstrate, I want to open a already saved document. So I go to File menu and choose Open. I want to open this nasa_1.pst file. Select and open it. Now the file is loaded. First of all, the guides are helps to place in the object. If you place outside the guides, it becomes invisible or hide. So very important to placing the object inside the guides. In your right side, you can see the layers panel. Inside of the layers panel, you can see three layers group: video group 2, video group 1, and video group 3. The layers group contain many objects inside. You can see the video group 2 as one text object, and the video group 1 as many video objects, as well as some adjustment layers. And the video group 3 contains one layer. If you turn off the visibility of the layers group, the objects disappear from the stage. The same layers you can see in the timeline panel. The video group 2 is on the top of all other layers group. It contains one text object. Video group 1 contains many video files. And video group 3 contains a one adjustment layer. And in the timeline panel, you can see the audio track also. And another one thing I want to say, all the videos are a individual layer in the layers group. If you want to turn off any individual layer, you can do it. I want to hide this layer once again. If I turn off the visibility, the layers is disappear from the stage. I want to turn it on. You can move this playhead wherever you want. Where is the playhead positioned? The stage shows that particular layer and the current frame of that layer. You can simply drag to move the videos. And you can see the layer stack in order also changed in the layers panel. Also, you can drag the clip one track to another, and you can see the video and the adjustment layer also moved group 1 layers group to group 2 layers group. I want to undo it, so I go to edit menu and undo. You can see the layer and the adjustment layer jumps back to video group 1 layers group. In the top of the timeline panel, you can see the controlling switch. This is frame forward button. You can forward one frame at a time. And this button for backward, you can go one frame backward at a time. The playhead moves back one frame at a time. And you can play through the play button. And if you want to go first frame, click this switch. Now the playhead comes to first frame. You can turn up the volume through this button. In the setting button, you can set the playback resolution. Now the playback resolution is 50. If you set to 100, if the video is high resolution. Now Photoshop take too much of time to play the video. Play it. You can see many dotted lines before the playhead. Now I click the first frame button. Now the playhead moves to first frame, and I want to set it 50% and the playback again. Now you can see a continuous line before the playhead. It indicates Photoshop play the video 50% of resolution, not the 100%. So Photoshop can play easily. If you set to 25%, you can see more smooth playback. And you can set the thumbnail size. Click this timeline menu button and choose panel option. Here you can set the timeline size small or large. I want to set large, so click this and click OK. Now the thumbnail size is increased. We can see the thumbnails easily. And now the time code shows minutes and seconds. You can change it to frame. go to menu button and choose panel option. Here you can set frame number. The time code is now converted to frame numbers. This is very useful to frame by frame animation. But I want to leave it minutes and seconds. So go to menu button and panel options. Reset to time code. Below you can see the timeline magnification slider. If you move it, the timeline converts to seconds. If you shrink it, the timeline convert to minutes and hours. You can go a particular time using the menu option. Click this menu and choose go to and choose time in the sub menu. You can set the time you want. I want to go 6 seconds and 16 millisecond and click OK. Now the time code moves exactly. Below you can see the exact time. You can set the commands for your reference. Click this menu option, choose show, and in the sub menu choose command track. Now the command track is appeared above all other tracks, and click this icon and type it you want and click OK. Now you can see the commands. Double click on it, the command shows. Now I want to change the thumbnail size, so go to menu button and panel option, choose medium size and click OK, and drag down the timeline. You can controlling the timeline by keyboard shortcut, and you want to enable them in Photoshop, it is turned off defaults. Go to menu button and here you can enable timeline shortcut keys. Click on it. Now you can able to play the video by spacebar and stop, and you can move the player by the arrows. Left arrow to move backward and right arrow to move forward one frame at a time. And if you use shift and right arrow, it moves multiple frames forward at a time. And if you use shift key and left arrow key to move multiple frames backward at a time. And if you press up arrow once, the playhead moves first frame of the timeline. Also you can use OM key to go to first frame and end key to go to last frame. If you select any particular video clip and if you press up arrow once, the playhead moves first frame of that video clip, and if you press down arrow, playhead moves end of the frames of that particular video clip. If you work on older or under power computer, you should set some preferences. Set playback resolution as 25%. Go to menu option. Here turn on allow frame skipping. It makes better playback, and you can set work area. In the sub menu, choose start a playhead and select how much work area do you want, and again go to menu button and work area, set in that playhead. Now if you play once, Photoshop plays only work area, and you can set loop playback, play over and over again. And if you drag it, you can rearrange the starting point and the ending point of the work area. And thank you for watching. Your command is very important to us. So command and give thumbs up sign, as well as subscribe our channel to receive new videos.